What is the plan that Gordon Hayward has? Where's he headed?
Well, first of all, good to see you, Dan. You look great. You know, clearly he's not part of their plans, which doesn't mean that he still might not come back to them for just 1 year. But there's no way that Gordon Hayward is opting out of $34 million a year unless he believes he can get a good deal someplace else. So could that be the Knicks? Could it be the Atlanta Hawks? Is he looking at perhaps a four-year deal worth between $80 and $100 million? It's hard to believe because if you look at the last 3 years, he's only played in 125 games. The first year was one game. The next year, I think it was about 70-plus games, but he was mostly a backup, and that was that first year back from injury. This year was 52, and he didn't play that well, and he wasn't really good in the playoffs, but it only takes one team, and a team like the Knicks, the Atlanta Hawks, they're looking to make big moves. So it looks like Gordon Hayward will likely be on the move. I think what the Lakers are hoping, I'm sorry, what the Celtics are hoping is that he will agree to a sign and trade so maybe they can get something back for him.
But see, why are the Knicks doing this? And then they're going to bring back Carmelo. It just felt like you got Obi Toppin, who's a wonderful kid. Like, R.J. Barrett's good. Like, just can they just be complacent, patient here for a little while and not go for the guy that's a big-ticket item who's coming off injuries or at the end of his career?
Well, I would say this. I think that Tom Thibodeau wants to win now. When I mean win now, I think he wants to be a playoff team. And the only thing I would say about that, look at the move. Now, it's a different player, but if you look at the move that the Phoenix Suns made, they haven't made the playoffs for 10 straight years. And Chris Paul has been in the playoffs for 10 straight years. And a couple of years ago, everyone would have said, that's the last guy you want on your team because of that contract. Look what he did to Oklahoma City last year, a team that a lot of people thought wouldn't be a playoff team. So everyone's value on that team increased because Chris Paul was there, including Dennis Schroeder, who just got traded to the Lakers. So I think if you're the Knicks, there comes a point, Dan, where you just can't be young all the time. It's about being good. It's about getting better. I say it all the time. If you want to be young and athletic, just draft a track team from a college, you know, get a bunch of 20-year-olds and run up and down. That's not what it's about. Sacramento has not made the playoffs for 14 straight years. They're young.
Yeah.
And I think the Phoenix Suns are in the same boat where they figured we have to make a move. And that's why I think if you're the Knicks, why not get a couple of veteran players, try to make the playoffs. You need to change the perception of the organization because the perception of the organization is you're dysfunctional and you're never good enough.